My name
for
is
having me on.
Thank you. My
Thank
name
you
is
so
Valichit
much.
Sarkar, Elite Mastermind Group. Jeff, go ahead and introduce yourself to everybody. Let us know where you're tuning in.
Definitely. Thank you so much for having me on today. I really am grateful for it. My name is Jeff Anzo. I'm tuning in from Athens, Ohio, and I'm currently a senior here at Ohio University.
Awesome, awesome. What are you studying, brother?
So I actually found a major where you get to design your own major, which is really cool. So I get to pick all my own classes, and I'm studying interpersonal relationships. So I have a hybrid of communication and psychology, and I'm also working towards an entrepreneurship certificate to give me a little management business background. So hopefully when I leave, I can start my own practice.
Awesome, awesome. So let's dive into it.
Yeah.
I know that you're a big advocate for gratitude. And you know, we're going to get into the books that you wanted to talk about, but let's talk about what the heck is gratitude and how do I start with it?
Definitely. So gratitude, you know, gratitude is just our ability to be loving and appreciative of the things that are around us in our present moment. And one of the ways that we can really practice this is to start thinking of some of the fundamentals that we take for granted all the time. You know, we're always looking for the next best thing to take us to the next level, to the next step, the next position. But what about the best thing that's in our life right now? And I've found just through my journey in life and through some of my successes that it's been through really just seeing what is in me and around me in the present moment and showing gratitude and just showing love for it. You know, one example, when I first started making videos, I didn't have equipment, I didn't have software, and I was like, oh, I'll start making videos in a year when I have the money and I have all these things. And I started thinking, like, be grateful for where you're at on campus. And I started looking around and I found computers with free software. So it's like, it was just really beautiful because through gratitude, I realized all the blessings are already in me in the present moment. And it just allows me to just be more grateful for it.
You got to be resourceful, man.
Yes.
Everything that you need is already there. I mean,
yes.
You could always modify and add to it, but it's already there. So how do I show my gratitude for the universe, for my loved ones? Is it just words? Is it based on action? How do I go through that process, letting everybody know? I know the self-talk, you got to be, you know, thankful for what you got and where you're at. That I already know. How do we go beyond that? What's the
yes.
next step?
Yes. And the best way to bring this into practice and then into your day-to-day lives with your loved ones, your families, coworkers, is it really comes down to your intention, I have found. You know, not always worrying about what exactly you're going to say, but what is the intention behind how you're saying it? You know, it's funny. I actually just put up on my door a little stamp or whatever that says, stay grateful, stay loving. So whenever I leave my house, my intention is rooted in that. And, you know, when I wake up every morning, I have a gratitude journal. And this literally, I recommend it to everybody. This changed my life. Every morning I wake up and I write just like about 10 things that I'm extremely grateful for. And when your mind is really fresh in the morning, you know, that's going to be the CD you're playing throughout the rest of the day. So, you know, I even get down to just being grateful for the fundamentals in life. You know, we're alive. Me and you are having a conversation, getting to connect and share each other's ideas. Like, so many basic things, you know, I would find myself complaining about cooking or doing my laundry. And I'm like, wait a second, I have clothes, you know, I have food. And it's just through these little micro reminders throughout the day of being grateful, it's just allowed me to look at my life with a whole different perspective and just be really at peace with where I'm at. But when engaging with people in different experiences, it really comes down to, I think, that intention. Before we got on this, I was thinking to myself the intention of, you know, the emotions and the feelings that we were going to speak about. So
definitely. So here's my question. Me and my wife, we always get into argument about traditional schooling. We both went to school. She's an attorney. I did biomed, right? But I'm a big advocate of not going to school.
Yeah.
Now, what I mean by that is I don't mean high school and bachelor's degree. That's not what I'm talking about. I'm talking about you making the excuse of you not having that degree for you not being in that field and not starting your action and relationships and contacts and just delaying that process till you have a little certificate that says, you know, you're able to drive a car. Well,
yeah.
You got to go to do a little test run You got to, you know, how to, you got to put, you know, gas in the car. You got to know how to use the blinkers. You got to know all the stuff before you get your license. But I know a lot of people that got their license and they're still not good drivers. So it's not that certificate that determines who you are. Everybody should know who they are and be able to work from that and go out. So here is my question. If you know there are a lot of entrepreneurs out there, I think the statistics, don't quote me on this, but I got to Google it, find out. I think 49% of millionaires didn't go to high school. I think it was 41% of billionaires didn't go to college. Something like some crazy astronomical number of millionaires and billionaires did not go the traditional way. That doesn't mean they didn't go to school. They can't read and write. I'm just talking about finishing getting a PhD degree. That's what I'm talking about. So tell me, what are you getting at school? And if I'm a student, how should I be navigating through traditional schooling so I'm not wasting my time?
Yes, I went through a huge revelation my sophomore year where I was invested in a major for the certificate, for the title and the price tag. And I had a huge falling out with this major my sophomore year. And I was like, what is going on? And I had to start reevaluating the entire college experience. And I was like, it's not just about, you know, going and living at the party scene or that piece of paper at the end. It's like the experience yourself, the people that are on campus. Some of the greatest tips I can give you right now is it's more than just the degree. Like you said, I love that. And on campus, what I do is I just network like a maniac. You know, I think about it in the sense of I'm not just paying for a piece of paper. I'm paying to have freedom to, you know, I found a major where I could design my own major. And a lot of schools, some schools offer this option. So if you're out there and you're like, you want to design your own little package, definitely look into it. It's a specialized studies program is what it can be called sometimes. But through this process of, you know.
You're talking about networking.
Yes, networking. Sorry, lost my process. Networking. And through networking, I've had to create my own experiences on campus. That's what it really came down to. You know, I love that you mentioned that we always wait for that wave or wait for that external permission before we can do something. And one of my friends, I told him, I go, I want to be a motivational speaker. And he's like, oh, when are you going to start? And I'm like, oh, in 40 years, once I have the experience. And he's like, well, what about right now? And I was like, really? And it like, and this is a great tip I'd like to throw out. Aaron Doughty, he's another influencer on YouTube. He talks about this. A lot of the times we think, once I have something, then I can do something, and then I can be something. But we need to look at it in reverse and say, I need to be, you know, for me, for example, I'm going to be a motivational speaker. I'm going to embrace the feelings and the mindset of one. I'm going to do habits and experiences that are aligned with that. And then, you know, I'll have the opportunities to travel and speak. And it's just a much more freeing way to look at it. So, you know, on campus, what I did is if you want to start a business, look at starting a student organization. So what I did about 2.5 years ago was start a student org where it's basically a gym for the mind. You know, we have gyms for our bodies where we get personal coaches and all these supplements. But what about our mind? You know, so what I do is I invite students in for weekly workshops on how they can reflect, how they can plan for the future and create meaningful action in the present moment that aligns with where they want to be in 15, 20 years down the line. And this student org, I'm now working with Entrepreneurship Center on campus to turn it into an actual business. So I'm very grateful to say I have not had the traditional college experience. I've really, but it's taken a lot of meaningful action. You know, there's nobody going to walk you around campus and say, here's this. You know, you have to really be.
You got to go get what's yours.
Yes.
You got to go get it. This is not one of those things that's being handed out in schools. You got to go get it. That's 100%. It. That's how it is. But I do agree with the networking part. I see so many people, especially right here in LA, California, right? USC, UCLA, all of these different schools, Pepperdine. You know, the parents, I think they understand it now more. You don't pay to get a degree from Pepperdine or USC. You're paying for that is partially there, but the rest is to get into the alumni of the schools and get to network with all these people, because somebody's dad has got the money to invest in your startup. Yeah. And if you haven't gone to school with their kids and you haven't gone to their parties and gatherings and this, you're not going to get that money. So you got to build that relationship around who you are, and some of those friends and some of those relationships take you to the next level. And you just, I mean, a lot of good things come out of it. I mean, worst case scenario, you build a lot of long lasting relationship and friendship.
Right.
That's the worst that could happen. You'll have more friends.
I love it.
So who's your favorite motivational speaker?
Tony Robbins, hands down. Tony Robbins.
Boo.
He is.
I'm messing with you. Tony's a good guy. I'm a Jim Rohn. I'm a Zig Ziglar. I'm a little bit more old school.
I just got into Jim Rohn recently. The five keys to
five seasons of life.
Yes. 5 Seasons of Life. And I've evolved to them through Tony Robbins. And it's just really, like you were just talking about on the previous live who you were on with, of going to the source. And it's like following Tony Robbins. Where did these ideas come from to that source, Jim Rohn and above? But I just really enjoy Tony Robbins' ability to just put on massive events. Like I really love his Netflix special where they show the inside look of how he goes about it, how he engages with the audience. And he does like counseling live in front of 500, you know, 1,000 people. And he's just very pure at heart. And I really admire
Tony's a good guy. But check this out. Let me tell you a story you probably haven't heard.
Yeah.
So one of Jim Rohn's friends was at one of his events. And Jim Rohn used to do events with like 500,000, 2,000 people. And then this event was like 40 people. And he was giving the same message, same style, same energy, everything the same as his big event. So one of his buddies asked, goes, listen, it's only like 40 people. You did the same thing that you did over there. It's the same thing, right? And he's all like, it doesn't matter, because I don't know where that one person is going to be at who this information is going to help him. It could be among those thousands of people, but it could also be among one of these 40 people sitting here. I don't know. So my job is to perform, give the best at all times. I can't pick and choose, say this event has got 1,000 people. I got to deliver way better than this group, which has got 40 people. So it's definitely, it's Jim Rohn is a big guy. And check this out. Jim Rohn and my grandpa are buried in the same cemetery.
Really? Where's
that at?
Which
is about 15 miles from my house.
That is
how crazy,
crazy
is that? How crazy is that? So I see it. If you go look at it, I mean, on Instagram, a lot of people go to this, you know, burial and everything else. They take pictures and they post it on Instagram. You could look it up. You got to go search it based on a hashtag or something, and you'll be able to see it. But Jim Rohn, good guy. I think his style of speaking definitely resonates with a lot of different people. So that's cool. But I tell you this, you should go on YouTube or on eBay to find the CD pack of his last convention that he did in 2004. You can get a hold of that recording, I'm old school. I got the CDs. I got all the CDs. But I'm pretty sure you will be able to find it on YouTube. It may not be a complete set, but I know on eBay people do sell it. It's not an Amazon thing. It's on eBay. So I bought that. But listen, I'm looking forward for you to become a very, very powerful motivational speaker. This is just the beginning. I'm going to be watching your Instagram. So I want to see a lot of live videos from you where you just putting it on the line. I don't even care if nobody's watching you. It don't matter. You're just putting it out there. It doesn't matter if it's one person watching or 1,000. You deliver the same thing, even if it's one person. So I'm looking forward to your growth. I highly recommend Think and Grow Rich to you. Highly recommend Think and Grow Rich. And whenever you finish with Think and Grow Rich, you let me know. We'll do another live session. I want to get your opinion on Think and Grow Rich.
I love it. Thank you so much for having me and for this opportunity again.
You got it, brother. Talk to you later, Jeff.
You enjoy. Have a wonderful day.
You got it. Bye-bye.